that with distributing the force over as large an area of the anvil as possible. There's a lot of force because it's the anvil in one of these, there's a lot of surface area. This is different to the hot cut. The hot cut has a tapered shank. That's all right. With the hot cut, we're putting all the force into the metal because the greatly reduced surface area of an edge means that you're going to sink into the metal more than you're going to be putting the force into the anvil. Just like if you were to take a flatter, see how much a flatter mushrooms after 10 blows, see how much a top cut mushrooms after 10 blows, flatter's going to mushroom a lot more. So on this particular one, larger surface area, you want to make sure there's a nice big, big flat bit at the bottom. So, what we could do is we could take our piece, put it in there, and just wail away and hammer. But that then leads to complications. Because naturally, as you guys have seen, when we take a large piece of steel, and we try and forge at the end of a large piece of steel, we get an enormous amount of fish mouthing. So what we need to try and do is we need to try and get as wide a base as possible while keeping the top as narrow as possible. Now we've got a few little conundrums that come into play before we do that. Because, firstly, when you hit something, the energy is going to dissipate to the top first. To the hand hammer, please. On a power hammer, it's actually the other way around. I don't know why. It moves more at the bottom than at the top. With hand hammers and strikers, when you hit a piece of metal, that energy is dissipating at the top. It means that when you hit a piece of metal, it's doing this more than it's doing this. It's just like one. Two is that the anvil is a heat sink. If we want a nice wide base, the bottom needs to be hot. If the bottom gets cold, you don't get a wide base. So what we've got is we've got two issues that are prompting it to, instead of forging down like this and getting a nice wide base, prompting it to forge like this, which means to get a wide enough base, you've got to go all the way over and then bring it back in. Which really means you go all the way over for the fish mouthing as it comes back in. So, the way that we compensate for this is we make it so that the only part of the tool that's malleable as we forge it is the bottom. Which means that we cool off the top, hammer, swell out the bottom. Bear in mind we don't want to cool off the top too much, otherwise we'll shatter it. But we also don't want to hammer too long in case the top heats up again, which it will. Heat will dissipate back through. And we don't want to hammer when the bottom is cold. As soon as there's blackness on the bottom, stop hammering in the back of the bar to heat it up. You cool off half of the heat. So you come into your water bucket, half the heat, cool it off. Then it takes about 10 seconds, maybe 15 seconds. Okay? Put it in there nice and fast. Set it. And start hammering. I'm not going away. I'm not hitting too hard. I'm making sure to hit right in the middle. Take your time. Make sure the top isn't heating loud up. And you see the bottom starting to cool down. And you're ready to take another hit.
Start lighting when we're ready to go. We're going to hit
harder and harder and harder and harder until we're done.
Alright.
Okay, so I'm giving it a little tap, tap, tap. The ball gets get it set all the way down. Great. Now I'm going to have a look at it, make sure that we're straight and centered. I'm going to give it a light blow. Then bar. Slow it down, lighter. I'm going to be looking at it, seeing if it's straight. I'm going to try and pull it over to myself. Damage it by over-forging. turn. Now have a look at it from the end. Face it back towards you, see if it's straight. Turn it upside down. Go ahead and hit the other side. Hard. Very nice. Have a look at it again. Make sure it's straight up and down. Again. Woo! So, now, all of that forging, all that's done is that's distorted and fucked up the eye a little bit.
Yep.
Seems a little funky. We want to see if we can go ahead and fix that.
Yep.
So now what we're going to do is we're going to take a heat, we're going to drive the drift, brush out of it, lay a flatter on it, hit the cheeks, brush it some more, check it straight in all the planes, and make adjustments as necessary. Leave them up there. Brush it. Get a bit of the flatter hard. Brush it again. We're gonna drive it a little bit more. So. Straight by looking down at the end. That I'm happy to fix with the grinder. The option, if we do want to fix it, is like this. Let in the hole. I might as well just kind of demonstrate it real fast. Okay, a medium blow. Away from people in case it flies off and hits Sam in the eyeball. Might do him a treat for his lips though. Hit it. Fair enough. I didn't go below the level of the cheeks. Back in the eye, polish it all up, brush it, pop off the scale, hit the cheek.